This is Colombo's shrine in Sri Lanka, 30 days after a suicide bomber killed around 100 people and left dozens injured during Mass. Since then, the liturgical celebrations have taken place in this chapel. The terrorist attack killed many people, yet people there have not lost faith. The children's choir is not afraid to participate in Mass with police security.
Actually, by God's grace and by St. Anthony's grace, none of the staffs or the choristers were injured badly, but only two choristers who were in the Tamil choir, who were celebrating the Tamil Mass that day, on that day. One girl couldn't hear for a few hours. Her ear was damaged, so for a few hours she couldn't hear anything, and the other girl was in a trauma of seeing everything. So except that, everyone was safe.
1 month after the tragedy, the 21-year-old St. Anthony Choir director offers a message of reconciliation.
Our God is a God of love, so, and God of mercy and compassion and forgiveness. So we come to church to listen to His words, and we were raised up by His words. So we forgive them. We forgive them for what they did, because at the end of the day, whoever died because of this attack, they have gone to our God. So they are in heaven in a happy place right now. So although the process was gruesome, we believe that they are with God now, praying for all of us here for the protection of us.
In the past week, for security reasons, it was not possible to celebrate Mass for the general public. These young people felt privileged.
We are happy at least we get this, because for like almost 3-4 weeks, the people outside who were not part of the choirs and altar service or the collectors, they were not able to celebrate a Mass. At least we got that chance. No matter how small the place is, it doesn't matter, I guess. At the end of the day, we are with God.
Representatives from Aids to the Church in Need managed to share a day with them. There they witnessed a spirit of reconciliation and the faith of Sri Lankan Catholics during the aftermath of the terrorist attacks.